The electro-insulator project shown in this video is an example of creating a dedicated custom program for your own specific purposes. It's a Microsoft Visual Studio project which creates a program to easily control electro for the study of a particular insulator. The project can be opened by unzipping the files in the API samples folder. This video will be broken into two parts. The first part demonstrating what this project does, the second part looking at the actual Visual Studio code. What you can see here is a simple program window showing a diagram of the device to be modeled, which is an insulator with top and bottom caps at specified voltages. There's a graph of electric field results for different cases studied, as well as a spreadsheet of the setup and the result conditions. There is also an area where you can specify all of the conditions that you actually want to run. This project then provides you with a template, including setting up autosave, getting and assigning properties to materials, then specifying different inputs related to your actual device. When we click the Run button, the program will invoke Electro, then draw the device within Electro and perform a standard analysis. You can see that it draws the insulator as specified by the setup on the left part of the project, then solves it, and it will draw streamlines from a portion of the top plate and show you the field values along the streamlines. It will also figure out the maximum field along the rounded edge of the top electrode surface, and will report this in the results area and add that field value to the plot. Let's modify this model by asking for 5 sheds instead of 3 sheds, then click Run and watch what happens in Electro. What we can see is that the maximum field on the rounded corner is lower in this case than the first case. We can now go ahead and try a multitude of things with this particular setup. We can make the outer radius much larger, choose a larger rounding radius for the edges of the plates, and so on. So in the end, what a user is able to do is create a very simple interface and from it make decisions based on looking at scenarios, tweaking numbers, and then seeing the results for the different variations that are being attempted. The results can be seen readily within the plot, but everything can also be exported. For example, in the spreadsheet, the numbers can be highlighted and using the usual shortcuts such as Ctrl+C to copy and Ctrl+V to paste, you can put it somewhere else. You can also save the results to a file named .csv, and now when we find and open the folder, you can see it open the data within Excel, including the header information. The other feature to take note of here is the autosave box, and that means that every case that's being studied is being saved to another case number to be reopened and examined later.